Every country has a police. That police takes care of criminality in its own country and cares for law and order. But what happens if a criminal leaves the country? Is he free? That's why there are several organizations to coordinate international police work. That starts in the country itself. In Germany, for example, it's the Bundeskriminalamt, the national police agency. It has a department for international coordination, and that department works together with other police organizations in the other countries. On the European level, that's Europol. Europol is an agency against big international crimes. On the global level, it's Interpol. Europol is a little bit smaller than Interpol. That means the countries don't have the same values in Interpol, whereas the European culture is quite similar in whole Europe. That makes the coordination in Europol far easier than it is in Interpol. Interpol started with an international criminal police congress. Nowadays, its headquarters is in Lyon. It counts 190 member countries. And the tasks of Interpol as well as of Europol is to connect data and information. Therefore, Interpol's function is informative and not executive. Interpol wants to activate national police agencies. It doesn't want to intervene in national police work. Interpol and Europol collect data about people, stolen documents, missed objects like cars or art, DNA data, fingerprints, and data to improper dealing with radioactive material. An example of how effective Interpol works was in 2014. A German banker steals 750,000 euros in a Stuttgart bank. He disappears. So the German police gives an international warrant. Interpol provided the warrant and information about the banker as data, so all 190 members were looking for him. 10 months later, he was arrested in Nairobi, Kenya. He spent 2 months in a Kenyan prison and was then delivered back to Germany. Well, you see, without Interpol and without globalization, Interpol wouldn't work, and all the gangsters would run around the world.